Okay, my name is Akiko Aizawa from National Institute of Informatics in Japan, and thank you very much for inviting me here. Actually, I'm not really working on bioinformatics, but we are rather focusing on general scientific domains. And today, since I have only a limited amount of time, I will briefly introduce our project at NII and also our efforts in analyzing PDF documents of scientific papers. So now, about NII, Professor Kim said that NII is the place where previous BLAH was held, and we are in the center of Tokyo, just next to the Imperial Palace. So we have a very good view on the 22nd floor of the building. And now there are two reasons why we are doing scientific paper analysis at NII. Here are the two reasons. First of all, NII operates scholarly information services, which is quite nationwide and target to mainly Japanese researchers. Our service is actually large scale. We have about 2 billion page per view per year. So we are seriously doing these services at NII. And the second reason is that there are several research projects that are focusing on natural language text, natural language processing based analysis of scientific papers. And one of them is CREST project titled Knowledge Discovery Through Structured Document Understanding, led by Professor Yuji Matsumoto. And this is our, how can I say, concept picture of how NII's current service, scientific information dissemination service, targets for. So we are keenly aware of open science, open research data now. So here we are trying to construct data storage and also secured data platform for to promote open science in Japan. And on the left top side, you can see that still it's important to identify links between scientific articles and research data in order to guarantee easy access to the data itself. And this is about the CREST research project. As you can see, in order to extract something from scientific papers, in view of natural language processing, there are many component techniques that we need to work on. So there's just a list of NLP component techniques we need to perform for scientific paper mining. And both of these points show that it's important to deeply analyze natural language, analyze scientific paper using natural language processing. And this is one of the famous news to us in 2 years from now, in 2016, that it tells that AI finally saved the life of a human in Japan. And this is a very encouraging news in scientific knowledge extraction. And in my perspective, this is not only achieved by the development of AI, but it is of course supported by a huge amount of money spent on publishing structured scientific articles and also human creation and the construction of databases and so on. And I know that biomedical text mining is so based on annotations, like the main focus in this workshop. However, the point we saw is that in other scientific domains, it's very difficult. So the question is that can researchers in other research fields enjoy such privileges? And the answer is probably no. And the reason is that we don't have any structured scientific articles or no human curation or not good research database. So unlike many people in this room, before annotate something, we need to extract natural language sentences from PDF documents. The reality is that in other domains, more than 80% of scientific literature is accessed as PDF documents. So we had to start from analyzing PDF documents from scratch. So the difficulty is that so human can recognize which part of this document is text and which line are connected to each other, and also easily distinguish captions from body of the text, but it's really difficult for human. And so and the reason is that in PDF documents, many different levels of structure information, including layout structure, logical structure, or semantic structure, and also higher levels of knowledge structure embedded in distinguishable. So it becomes very mixed and messy in PDF documents. And what we are trying to do by analyzing PDF structure right now is to keep both different levels of structure information, like annotations on natural language sentences, with location information on PDF documents. So difficulty is that the document is two-dimensional, while natural language sentence is just a sequence of words. So we are trying to keep all the location information in this middle XML representation. So this is how our viewer looks like. So the right side is the original PDF document, and the left side is the extracted XHTML document. So you can directly view the documents in XHTML documents once our analysis tool is applied. And you can have a correspondence, location correspondence with PDF, and also the sentence in the document. So this is an enlarged picture of it, and we do very small, tiny things to improve the quality of the extracted sentence. This shows that we identify inline mass notations, like R is not a word but a mass formula. So we recognize R as a mass formula, and also we identify independent mass formula and identify it as a component of a single sentence. It's not independent line, but considered as a component of a single sentence. So the single sentence can be red flag on the left side, denoting the concatenated d-dimensional word representation. As a mass formula, we have the following probability definition: mass, where mass, and so on. So we can recognize that the text is continuous in the single sentence. And this is how the extracted XML representation looks like. So it has all words with its location information and the font type and so on. And this and also because there can be some errors in the analysis, we provide some tools for manually correcting PDF analysis errors here. And what this enables is that we can create many intelligent user interfaces and reflect reflect the annotation result directly on PDF documents when browsing. So this is an example, and also sound, and this is an example of on the left side, we do some wikification, technical term wikification, and a Wikipedia article shown on the side note of the page. This is done by my colleague, Abekoro-san, and on the right side, you can see that the dependency annotation is visualized on PDF documents, and the dependency of words is automatically extracted by applying the tools. And so we, based on this, we construct many demonstration paper bureaus with the functions, and also this is an example of my collaborator, Professor Yoshioka at Hokkaido University, do some intensive analysis of only caption part of the picture, because in material science, figures are very important, and important information is described in the caption part. So it's a location aware search enhancement. And this is enhancement with mass formula and so on. So that's all my presentation. Thank you very much.